Hey, my name's Mark. I'm a chef living in Paris. One of the best things about living in France is the great quality of produce here. This morning, I got up early to do one of my favorite things. Paris is still on lockdown, but the open air markets are still open, and that's where I was this morning. I came home with lots of great stuff, and we're gonna use that today to make a ceviche. So let's get started. The ceviche we're doing today is a sea bream ceviche. You can also use other kinds of fish. Tuna works really well, as does salmon or sea bass. There's no external heat source for this, but I am going to be layering in different kinds of acids like vinegar, lime, and these pickled kumquats here. Those aren't necessary, but if you want to know how to make them, you can check out the link in the description. Even though we're not cooking the fish in the oven or on the stove, that acidity is actually going to change the fish chemically. So it wouldn't be right to say that that fish is raw, which is great if you're not a fan of that slimy texture. Fish, olive oil, and avocado are also sources of good fat, and that's gonna add a really rich, bold texture to the dish as well. As you can see, there's a lot of prep here, so let's get started on that. Most of these ingredients are gonna go together in a sort of mango salad. It's a bit like pico de gallo here. I'm gonna cut this bell pepper really small. It's gonna be nice texture and color. And I'm scraping that middle part out with a spoon. I'm cutting with the skin side down because the rough side is a lot easier to slice through. These last few I'm going to set aside for garnish. I'm gonna cut this chili pepper the same way. Make sure you get the seeds out because those are really hot. Be careful not to touch your eyes when you're handling hot peppers. I've definitely learned that the hard way. I'm gonna go wash my hands to get the oils off. I'm gonna peel this onion and then we'll get a fine mince on that. I'll save just a few of these for garnish as well. I'm gonna mince this cilantro, but I'm gonna set a few of these leaves aside for garnish later. I'm setting aside the prettier ones. And then I'll chop these up. I'm not gonna need quite all of this. That should be enough. Not everybody loves cilantro. You can always use parsley instead. I'm gonna cut this mango now. This can get a little bit messy, so be prepared for that. The pit on a mango is pretty big, so we're gonna try to cut around that. Now we'll do the same thing on the other side. Be careful with this, this can get slippery. Now I'm gonna cube this. Notice that I'm using a butter knife. You can easily cut yourself with this, so I've learned from experience. Gonna make kind of a tic-tac-toe board with this. Now I'm going to spoon this into the mixture with mango. The trick is to take what you've got and sort of invert it on itself. And then going about halfway, you got your nice little cube. And now I'll do the same thing with the other side. Thank you. I'm getting ready to dress the salad. So I'm slicing this lime into wedges so it's easier to get the juice out. I'm gonna go ahead and add oil, white wine vinegar, salt, Espelette pepper, and then some lime. Okay, I'm gonna mix this all together now. Yeah, that's really good. I'm just gonna add a little more salt and just a touch of oil. Now I'm gonna set this aside for later. Even though this fish won't be raw because the acidity cooks it a little bit, you do wanna ask the fishmonger what the freshest catch of the day is. You can also really taste the difference. And because we're not applying heat to this, you don't have all the germs killed in the same way that you usually would when you're searing a fish, say. One way to do this would be to cut the fish into similar size pieces as the mango. I'm gonna do it a little bit differently though. I'm gonna cut these into small, but kind of uneven pieces. I asked the fishmonger to take the skin off for me as well. I also had him take the little bones out because those can be a choking hazard. I'm gonna clean this board so it doesn't smell like fish forever. Now I'm gonna marinate the fish. More of these lime wedges, olive oil. I'm using a white balsamic vinegar. If you're buying all the ingredients for this new, you can use just the white wine vinegar. You can also use something that you already have on hand. I'm avoiding browner vinegars because that will discolor the fish. Finish it off with a little bit of salt and some Espelette pepper. Already you can see how the color and texture on this are changing because of the acidity from the vinegar and the limes. Let's give that a taste. Gosh, really good. Just a tiny bit more salt and some more lime. And then I'll set that aside. A lot of recipes that I really love involve prep that you can do far in advance. This is not one of those recipes. You can do that with the mango salad, but the rest of it you wanna do as close to when you're serving it as you can. I'm gonna use a mandoline to slice these radishes. I'm gonna marinate these radishes with some oil, more of that white balsamic, some salt, now I'm gonna get these avocados into nice cubes. This is another thing that you wanna be careful with. Some of the worst cuts I've seen in the kitchen come from avocados, so I never use a sharp knife to do this. No, no. And that is why I don't use a sharp knife. Okay, so I'm gonna get some nice slices on this avocado. I'm gonna put a little bit of lime on that so it doesn't turn brown. I'm gonna slice up these chives for garnish. And then I'm gonna get just a few slices of this pepper. So we're finally done with all that prep. We've got some beautiful mise en place here. This kind of prep work is what you spend most of your time doing in a professional kitchen. Usually this would all be done before anybody even arrives in the restaurant. So we're gonna start plating this now. We'll start off with the fish. You can really see how that coloration has changed and how the acidity has cooked this. Space these out fairly evenly. Now I'll add the avocado. Sort of going in between these fish. Now I'm gonna put the mango in. Sort of toss that over, trying to fill the blank spaces. Now I'm adding the radish. Pickles. I decided this would also look nice with pickled onion. Again, if you want to know how to make these, you can see the link in the description below. Get those chilies on there. Finish off with some chives. And just a little bit of Espelette pepper. And we are all done. That is a pretty plate. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. You can like and subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you next week.